This is radio station OKKK in Tuna, Texas, serving the greater Tuna area at 275 watts, signing on.
Merry Christmas, Tuna. This is Thurston Wheeler.
And this is Arliss Struve.
And this is the Wheeler.
Struve Happy Holiday Report.
And first off in the news, we have the finalists of the OKKK Christmas Yard Display Contest, and we've been waiting on this one.
We have.
And leading the competition. Leading that competition, as usual, is the display at the home of W.H. and Vera Karp. This year, the Karp Yard Display is titled the Christmas Hall of Fame, and it consists of a traditional nativity scene complete with live sheep. Well, the Holy Family is shaped out of hard plastic and lit from the inside, and it's surrounded not only by the wise men and shepherds, but the crowd also includes Santa Claus, Bing Crosby, the Grinch Who Stole Christmas, and Natalie Wood. Still in the running is Dee Dee Snavely, with her gigantic Christmas tree constructed out of aluminum pie pans and colored floodlights called Oh, What a Heavenly Light.
Oh. You can see it as far off as Dewey County.
It draws bugs in December.
It does.
It does.
It does. It does.
Well, the heat it puts out is awful.
Ah.
Still in the thick of the competition is the controversial entry over at the duplex of I Need a Good One and Helen Bed. Now, that entry is titled All I Want for Christmas and consists of two life-size cowboy mannequins stuffed inside huge Christmas stockings hanging off the front porch balcony. Well, a lot of folks were upset by that.
Oh, hell, Sheriff Givens tried to arrest Anita and Helen.
Thought he had a double homicide.
He did. Next up, the local chapter of the Smut Snatchers of the New Order is offering a $50 reward and an autographed copy of the Reverend Spike's new book, Cleaned Up Deuteronomy, for any information leading to the arrest of the infamous Christmas Phantom who's wreaked havoc in the greater Tuna area for years. Now, it seems the Phantom struck again last night and loosened all the bulbs on the community Christmas tree and just ruined the big moment before Garlinda Crump was to sing Oh Holy Night.
Yeah, well, she's still not over the hurt.
She's not. So, if you have any information about the Christmas Phantom, give Vera Karp a call over at the Smut Snatchers of the New Order. She'll be running the organization till the Reverend Spikes gets out of prison. Next up, on a somber note, the Coweta Baptist Church, in conjunction with the Drop Back and Punt Club, is conducting a 24-hour prayer vigil for head football coach Raymond Chassie as he tries for the third time to pass the Texas State Teacher's Competency Exam. And if he flunks it again this time, he's going into politics. So, get out there to that Coweta Baptist Church and pray.
Yeah. Well, Arliss, you never know what you got till it's gone.
You don't. We'll have more on that story as it develops, but right now it's time for the public opinion section of our show, Tuna Speaks, and today's concerned citizen is none other than Tuna's own Elmer Watkins. Elmer?
This is Elmer Watkins for Clan 249. Inviting you to our annual Christmas family night and skeet shoot. Now, the theme of this year's family night is the whitest Christmas ever. And, well, it'll consist of fun and education for the whole family. And you wear something white and get a free raffle ticket for our door prize, a butane-powered flamethrower. And after last year, I must remind all of you our new rule, prohibiting flammable liquids where women and children are present. And I feel very personal about this issue, and you would too if all your eyebrows had been burned off and never grew back. That's why I wear my cap so low, it's embarrassing. This is Elmer Watkins for Clan 249 saying season's greetings.
Thank you, Elmer, I tell you. Folks, it's such a joy to be here in the greater Tuna area when that Christmas spirit starts to take hold. It is.
It is.
It is. It
yeah,
is.
Yeah, I get all choked up inside.
Well, you've always been emotional.
I have.
He has. Now, let's see. Next up on the local theatrical scene, the much-troubled Tuna Little Theater production of A Christmas Carol by Charlie Dickens will go on as scheduled, according to artistic director Joe Bob Lipsy. Now, Joe Bob, as you know, has become a local legend for his innovative staging techniques, which gave us the unforgettable Greek tragedy of Medea set in Yazoo City, Mississippi, in which Medea's husband dumps her for a waitress from Cincinnati, forcing her to strangle her kids rather than let them grow up with a Yankee stepmother.
Man, I tell you, that Joe Bob now, he's a creative fella.
He is. Now, Christmas Carol will be a traditional staging, according to Lipsy, who says all financial contributions will be chipped in to pay for the theater's overdue electric bill. But City Secretary Dixie DeBerry says if they don't pay up by Christmas Eve, they'll be singing in the dark.
Yeah, well, you know what it is, Arliss, is Dixie's upset over last year's musical. Joe Bob said she was too old to play Mame.
Well, hell, she's older than water.
She is.
She is. She's about half mean, too. You remember when she cut off the lights at the homecoming game just before halftime?
Yeah, and that poor little twirler had a baton 30 feet in the air.
She did.
She did, yeah.
She did. She did. Caught her right below the eye.
Oh.
Now, Thurston, you got that farm report?
Yeah, I got that farm report. Well, it's around here somewhere. I don't know where the damn thing is. Ronnie! Well, I hate it when I have to make it up. Well, I know cantaloupes were higher than a city skirt the other day, and there's something we're not supposed to eat. Well, hell, here it is. Well, let's see. We got beef unchanged, pork unstable, chickens uneventful. Not a thing on here about Sowbilly, so we'll go to a commercial now from our sponsor, D.D. Snavely of D.D.'s Used Weapons. Christmas, Dee Dee. Merry Christmas.
And a holly jolly Christmas to you too, Thurston. This is Dee Dee Snavely asking you, do you know how dangerous it could be during this day and age to ride unarmed in a one-horse open sleigh? Well, lay those fears to rest, cause D.D.'s is stocked to the ceiling this Christmas with weaponry for the home, the car, and the workplace. God forbid during this joyous season that anyone listening should become the victim of a Christmas theft, but wouldn't you rather shoot someone than watch them run off with your new toaster? I know I would. So whether it's a stun gun, judo clubs, or just a simple old-fashioned switchblade, when you come to D.D.'s, you'll have a holly jolly Christmas, and the criminal will have a silent night.
Thank you, D.D. Thank you. Folks, if you can't be with your family this Christmas, or if your loved ones are driving you right up the wall, just plan to come on down to the OKKK Christmas party and cover dish supper.
You know, I've gone to that party every year since Trudy and I got divorced, and I tell you, I never had a better Christmas.
Yeah, well, I kind of miss old Trudy.
Oh, me too.
Yeah.
Oh, I miss Trudy like a rash.
Oh, now. Now, where's your Christmas spirit?
Don't get me going. Trudy and I got divorced over Christmas.
That's right.
She wanted a set of Japanese steak knives for Christmas. I got her a heating pad instead.
Yeah, and that's when she poured all that grapefruit juice in the punch.
Oh, she sure as hell did. She knew I was allergic to grapefruit juice, and she sneaked in the kitchen, poured God knows how much of it into the punch.
Yeah, I remember it made you itch.
Itch. Itch. Hell, I scratched so hard the doctor made me wear mittens. I still had them on in divorce court.
He did?
I did. Yeah. I did. Trudy, if you can hear my voice, you're too close. Yeah, you're too close. And from our world news desk, Christmas violence continues, no end in sight, leaving thousands homeless in hell. I can't even pronounce the name of the place.
Well, it must be way off.
Must be. Well, folks, they must be foreigners, so never mind.
Never mind. This is
and Arlie Struve saying happy holidays.
This is Petey Fisk speaking to you for the Greater Tuna Humane Society, and I'd like to encourage each of you looking for Christmas pets not to succumb to that urge to acquire an exotic animal, because after a few weeks the new wears off and I end up with it. Now, you may think it's cute to teach barroom language to that minor bird, but when your fundamentalist relatives come to visit and that bird wakes them up at dawn cussing a blue streak, what do? You give it to me. That baby alligator's a family favorite when he's no longer than your finger, but 10 months later when he hisses at your sister-in-law and tries to mate with your luggage, what do? You give it to me. Exotic pets have mean streaks, and I got the stitches to prove it. Skunks are moody, raccoons are self-centered, and wild hogs have a zero success rate as yard pets. So say no to that wild animal. If nothing else, it'll cut your doctor bills. As my grandma used to say, you just give nature some space and it won't try to kill you. This is Petey Fisk speaking to you for the Greater Tuna Humane Society. Thank you.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue thinking about you. Decorations of red on a green Christmas tree.
This is Leonard Childers speaking to you on radio station OKKK and welcoming you to Leonard's Let the Stops Out radio shopping spree. Remember, if you can't find it at Leonard's, you're too picky. So I encourage all of you out there to call in and buy something.
Kitty, 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 kitty. Where did you come from, cat? How did you get in this house, and what's wrong with you? No, don't you go up in there, Jody!
What?
Get yourself down here, pronto. Get off of that, Jody!
What?
Get off that crack velvet now, not to... You get out of that tree!
I guess you found the cat.
Oh, yeah, is that what it is? I want that cat out of there now.
Oh, Mama, she's gonna have babies.
Not here, she's not. And I don't have to ask you where you got it. Only Petey Fisk would dump a pregnant cat on me at Christmas time.
Doesn't have any place to go, Mama. Petey said all this cat needs is a warm blanket and some straw, just like the manger.
Jody, I am not playing midwife to some pregnant cat. Now, I've got too much to do today. I have a smut snatchers meeting at noon. I have a Frito pie to make for the radio station. I'm supposed to be at Coach Chassie's prayer vigil. Haven't finished decorating these Christmas cookies. Your father hasn't called. Stanley gets off probation tomorrow, and the whole town thinks he's the Christmas Phantom.
Well, I know who the Phantom is.
When your sister finds out that we have a cat, she'll have one herself. You know Charlene is allergic to cats.
Well, maybe she'll pass out. We won't have to listen to her squawk.
Honey, if she does, I'll make you hold her feet up until she comes to. Now, that cat is going back to Petey Fisk today. Charlene, Renee! Stanley Gene, get down here now, or I'm going to put on the Andy Williams album.
Mama, you promised last year not to play that record again.
Honey, your father promised not to miss another Christmas. Hitler promised to stop after Czechoslovakia. Hello? Hello, Aunt Pearl. Merry Christmas. No, Hank hasn't called yet. Well, I think he's caught in that snowstorm out in Amarillo. Well, it's supposed to snow there sometime. No, Stanley is not up yet, but he ought to be. Well, I'll send him over there, Aunt Pearl, but I don't want him out in the public eye too much today, not with all this Phantom business going on. Yeah, I know. Sometimes I wish Stanley would just up and leave this town. Will you tell Uncle Henry I'll be by sometime tomorrow with his chocolate-covered cherries? No, I don't trust Charlene after last year. I removed the pits myself. I know it's a blessing you knew the Heimlich maneuver. I love you too, Aunt Pearl. Goodbye. It's a cat about to have kittens. And when she does, she's going to the garage. Now you just sit out and eat.
Grody, after seeing that, I'll never eat again.
Charlene, don't lie.
I'm not. Besides, being Joe Bob's assistant director of the community theater comes first. Who has time to eat?
Whatever you have to do for Joe Bob can wait. He's never missed a meal for you or anyone else from the looks of things.
Well, you'd eat too if that old Philistine Dixie DeBerry is threatening to cut off your lights on opening night and you were the most brilliant director who'd ever lived, so don't knock Joe Bob, mother. He's the only sensitive person in this hole in the road. If he moves back to Lubbock, I'll kill myself, so there.
Oh, Charlene, honey, Baptists do not kill themselves.
Well, I'll start a new trend.
Charlene, how's play practice?
Well, it's awful. Thanks to you and those goofy old smut snatchers. Who ever heard of a dirty word in Christmas Carol?
Well, Vera Karp says they're there. And Charlene, the smut snatchers are here for everyone's protection. Censorship is American as apple pie, so shut up. And I want you to stick around the house today, honey. I want to take pictures of the whole family so we can put them on Christmas cards next year. Get your daddy home long enough to sit still for one.
Well, I know what. Next time Daddy passes out drunk in front of the TV set, let's just gather around the couch, take a picture of that.
Charlene!
Wouldn't that be pretty on a Christmas card?
Charlene, don't make me slap you this near Christmas. Well, you come on over here and you help Mama decorate the tree.
That is a sick tree. Connie Carp's tree touches the ceiling. Has plastic icicles that look like real ice.
Connie Carp's parents have more money than we do. Charlene, stop throwing the icicles. Here, honey, hang up your little angel. You remember when you made that?
I never made that. You say that every year.
Now, I'm going to hang it up right over here next to Stanley's little license plate. Do you remember when he made that in reform school? Now, Charlene, come and help me. It's no fun decorating a tree by yourself.
You know. You know. You know. I wonder why Joe Bob's never been married.
Charlene, I don't think Joe Bob is the marrying kind.
Well, why?
Well, honey, Joe Bob has always been different.
Well, what is that supposed to mean?
Well, it just means that he's out of the ordinary.
You are so cruel.
Honey, you know I like Joe Bob. Now come and help me with these icicles. It'll be fun.
I don't want to. I can't afford to waste my artistic integrity on that pathetic little shrub.
Charlene, you have 5 seconds to get in the Christmas spirit before I hair-lip you.
All right. Happy,
Charlene,
happy
stop it, honey, stop it. Don't throw the icicles when you... Charlene! Honey, you get that meanness from your daddy.
Oh, and speaking of mean, would you please tell Stanley to rinse out the tub when he's there? I get totally grossed out every morning.
You be nice to Stanley. He has a lot on his mind.
That's impossible.
Honey, today is his last probation hearing. Now, that is a Christmas blessing.
Oh, yeah, it'd be a Christmas blessing if he's back in jail.
He is nervous enough about playing that part in A Christmas Carol.
I don't know why. He stands there staring like he's in a lineup. Everybody knows he's the Phantom. It's just a matter of time before he's back in prison.
He was in reform school. Your daddy was in prison.
It's the same thing.
Charlene, that part that he's playing is the last of his community service. Now, I think you need to show your twin brother support.
The community service if he left town.
Stanley is not going anywhere.
That's not what I hear.
And where are you going?
I don't have to tell you everything.
Well, fine. Then you just stay gone all day, young lady, and I'll lock you up with the dogs, and you can get Joe Bob Lipsy to feed you.
Well, thank you, Joan Crawford.
Hello? Hello, Ike. Nice of you to call back. Well, you may not want to wish me a Merry Christmas after you hear what I have to say. Yeah, listen, Ike, I want you to have my husband call his home. You don't know where he is. Well, Ike, I suggest you finish your Christmas brew, get off your Christmas butt, and go find him. Yeah, you'll find him, because if you don't, the next message I leave will be with your wife, Ida. Do you remember Ida? And I'm telling her about that red-headed bank clerk that you and Leonard and my husband and half the men in this town play poker with in Sand City. I'm already mad. I had to leave a message at this nasty beer joint you're in, and I'm spraying this phone down with Lysol when I hang up. If I don't hear from my husband by this afternoon, I'm cashing in his poker chips and yours. Now you try and have a merry one. I'm a desperate woman. Stanley, get down here now.
Chestnut pots roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like a...
Damn, Mama, your mean streak sure shows itself at Christmas time. You know that?
Well, it didn't used to. Everyone has called here this morning but your father, so stop complaining. Charlene is bad enough. And Jody is there in the pantry with a mean and pregnant cat ready to bingo any minute now. If Santa Claus walked through that door right now, I'd set his beard on fire.
Boy, that is just what we need is a cat. A cat. Little moody, foul-tempered thing with claws that sheds. Hell, we got that with Charlene.
Stanley, will you stop slandering your sister?
Actually, cat's a step up.
Honey, did you get your sister anything for Christmas?
No, they were all out of sheep dip.
Well, I went ahead and I got her something for you. And Stanley, I hope no one we know is involved in this Christmas phantom business.
Mama, I've been at play practice every time the phantom struck, so just get off. I got an airtight alibi.
That's what worries me.
You know, you're just like everybody else in this town. I'm so nice to people, they treat me like...
Stanley, damn it, don't cuss on Christmas. And that was real nice of you to hide your Aunt Ruby's new glass eye.
I put it where she could find it.
In the refrigerator.
What? She shouldn't have left it out on the TV. I couldn't even watch Soul Train without that eye staring back at me.
Stanley, don't let your daddy catch you watching Soul Train.
Hell, that glass eye didn't even match your good one.
Well, she got that eye on discount. She's always been frugal.
Yeah. She's always been cheap.
Honey, just shut up about that eye before I throw myself off a water tower. And I don't want to argue with you today. I do enough of that with your father.
Why don't you leave him?
Honey, I don't want to talk about divorce on Christmas.
Hell, he won't even let you play bingo.
Well, gambling is a sin.
He never takes you to the movies.
They haven't made a good movie since Audie Murphy died.
Did you get that microwave last Christmas? No.
Well, I changed my mind. Your Aunt Ruby got one of those and all her body hair fell off.
Never mind, Mama.
Stanley, let's try and have a decent Christmas. Now here, this is your gift to Charlene. It's that new cologne compromise. I want you to wrap it up and put it under the tree.
Oh, great. Mama, God, what are you thinking? Have you smelled the bathroom?
Well, I can't do anything right.
Oh, it's all right. Mama, I'll wrap it up. I'll wrap it up. Well, hell, we ought to tell her it ain't deodorant. She lays it on like a crop duster.
Will you stop it?
What do you want for Christmas, Mama?
Your father here.
Well, what's your second choice?
Well, he might show up. Don't eat the eyes off those clown cookies. Honey, those are for the MYF.
When did we turn Methodist?
Well, we didn't. I'm just getting extra spending money. Aunt Pearl called this morning. She wants you over there. Something about a blue jay and that banty rooster.
Are they going at it again?
Yeah, now, don't drink out of the carton. And Stanley, please don't go to your last probation meeting today looking like a zombie. Wear a shirt and tie.
I don't own a tie.
Now, come on over here.
Why?
Come here. I want you to hold this.
Well, Mama, what for?
Damn, Mama. God, I wish you'd warn me before you do that.
Well, at least I'll have one picture of you at Christmas time. Stanley, why don't you stay here a while and help me with these icicles?
Yeah, looks like Charlene's already done that. Hell, that tree looks like Baby Jane had a go at it.
Honey, don't you want to be here when we put the star on the tree?
Oh, take a picture.
Take a picture. Take a picture. What has happened to this family? Christmas used to be so special. Now it's every man for himself. I can't even get my family together for a picture. Well, it's not fair. I guess the good Lord has other plans for us. And I could use a little peace on earth. Hello?
Bertha.
Hello, Vera.
Bertha. Bertha. What are we going to do about that Christmas phantom? He's hit every house on the block but mine.
I don't think about it much, Vera. We don't have a yard display.
Hang on. Loopy. Loopy, darling. Darling, hang that on a lower branch. Va-ha-lo, Loopy. Bring it down. Va-ha. Are you there?
Yes, Vera.
Well, I suppose the Phantom can't be here, Stanley. He's been at play practice with Virgil, so apparently has an alibi. And if he does turn out to be the Phantom, I just pray they don't throw him in jail till after Christmas. You've been through so much already. How do you hold up?
I'm used to it.
Oh, and about Stanley's probation, I baked him a cake. But if he does mess up before the hearing, we'll just freeze it and we'll have it when he gets out of jail.
Well, you've always been thoughtful, Vera.
Oh, it's nothing. We have those super ply freezer bags. I can't remember the name. Hang on. Loopy, darling, where are El freezer bags? Por favor. Freezer bags. Freezer bags. Oh, never mind. Lord, sometimes it's like a scene from the miracle worker around here. I remember why I called you. I know what's wrong with your Christmas tree.
What?
Well, put on some coffee and I'll come over and show you.
No, Vera, that's
no trouble. I'm just across the street. I'll be right there.
Vera, I don't have time. Well, this Christmas is going to take 10 years off me. One child in the pantry with a pregnant cat. Another with one foot in jail. And Charlene's in love with a sissy. I swear. I wish Joe Bob would go back to Beaumont or Corpus or wherever it is he goes. Take his movie posters and his Broadway soundtracks with him. If I hear Bally High one more time, I'm throwing Charlene out of the house. And now Vera Karp is coming over here to redecorate my Christmas tree.
Knock, knock.
Come in, Vera.
You have such a lovely view of my yard display from here.
Yes, we do.
Oh! Mm-hmm. I know what's wrong with this tree.
What?
You need to turn the bad side to the wall.
We did.
Well, I know what. I'll give you all my old ornaments. You can fill in those bare spaces. I gave them to Loopy, but I'll make her bring them back. She really doesn't appreciate nice things.
Here, have you completed your dirty word list from Christmas, Carol?
Well, of course I have. I'm head of the obscene committee, remember?
Well, what's the verdict?
Well, merry gentlemen have to go.
Merry gentlemen, why?
Oh, Bertha, you know those people talk in codes.
Oh, yeah.
And there's just been a storm of controversy about round young virgins.
Vera, that's round yon virgin.
Oh. Well, too late. They're already out. You know I'm not comfortable singing about virgins in any case. We'll leave that to the Catholics.
Yeah.
Well, I am just an overheated downhill wreck with four flats riding on the rim and the jack doesn't work about that yard display contest. Now, if we win again, we'll retire the trophy.
I know how much that means to you, Vera.
That trophy is so lovely. It would mean so much to me personally to win 15 years in a row. Virgil? 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 Leave that sheep alone and it won't bite. You know, they say sheep aren't aggressive, but all three of these in the yard display have bitten Virgil.
Well, I guess they've had enough.
Well, I know how they feel. Lord. I've tried everything to keep him out of that yard display. Barbed wire, baling wire. Dee Dee Snavely tried to sell me that stuff they use on the Mexican border, but Lord, that didn't even slow Loopy down. She's scared of the garage door opener. Virgil, 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 don't grab that sheep there. That's why he charges.
Vera, you should have him seen, too.
Well, have him sheared and slaughtered by New Year's. And as for Virgil, he's off to military school in No Hope, Arizona, and I pray they can do something with him.
Vera, I'm expecting Hank anytime.
Well, you could just be waiting all day. Virgil? Virgil, stop chunking rocks at the Holy Family. They've just been repainted. Put that down. Drop that gravel. Behave. No. Well, do you think Dixie DeBerry will cut off the lights at the community theater?
Well, if they don't pay their bill, I'm sure she will.
It'd be a shame to have them do all that work and have it not happen. And WH and I would ordinarily pay the bill, but Lord, times are hard. We could barely afford to buy new cars this year. Hang on, he's got the baby. Virgil, put that down. You're going to get shocked. That baby is wired with electricity. Put the baby down now. I don't know how he got that out. I paid Julio minimum wage to glue that baby into that manger. Let me ring you later.
Oh, Vera. Vera, good luck on the contest. Well, it's just you and me now, little tree. Let's see if we can fix you up. Charlene has thrown ice everywhere. God, just hope it looks a little better. I just want to get through this day. Shut up, get out!
Yeah!
Come on in, Arliss, I'm sorry. I think that just means he likes you.
Well, hell, if he liked me anymore, we'd have to get married.
Yeah.
That's a cute little dog you got out there, Bertha.
Well, Chiquita's a little hyper.
Oh, I used to have one just like her when I was a kid. Yeah, she had a little old tiny ping pong ball head.
Uh-huh.
She had little bitty marble eyes.
Oh,
and
yeah.
She shook all the time.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
We took her on vacation to Yellowstone, and a hawk got her the first 10 minutes.
Oh, Arliss, that is terrible. Arliss, would you like a cup of coffee?
Well, actually, I came by to see Hank. Somebody turned his wallet in at the radio station.
Where did they find it?
Well, I can't say as I recall.
Well, you can tell me, Arliss. I'm used to Hank.
Well, as I recall, it was in a parking lot.
The parking lot of the Starlight Motel, wasn't it?
Yeah. As I recall, it was. I'm sorry.
Well, I appreciate you bringing it by.
If it makes you feel any better, I know just how you feel. Trudy came home one time wearing Fruit of the Looms. Well, I gotta run. I got a lot of stuff to do before the party. Now, you come by the party if you feel like
well,
it.
Well, I just might do that.
Well, Merry Christmas, Bertha.
Well, Merry Christmas to you too, Arliss. Lord, Christmas used to be so simple. Well, not always. I remember that Christmas Hank was in prison. And I was working at the Tasty Cream, cooking on Christmas Eve. And that bread man from Odessa begged me to run away with him. He meant it too. He'd been drinking, but I know he meant it. Just where would you be now, Bertha? Well, I wouldn't have my babies, and I wouldn't trade that for anything.
Mama? Mama?
Oh, no, not now. Cat, please. Oh, dear. Jody, it's all right. Now, Miss Kitty, calm down. No one's going to bother you. Jody, reach up there. Get that box down, honey. Hurry. We're going to need it.
The snowman was a jolly happy soul with a out of coal. Frosty the snowman had a broomstick up our damn it. Get in here.
Yeah, Dee Dee. I'm right here.
Right here in my rear. What'd you do with those dud grenades? I need a few more to finish trimming that tree.
Well, the last time I saw them, Dee Dee, your mama was going through them in the powder room.
What? Well,
in the powder
the
room.
The powder room. God. Damn it, R.R. How many times have I warned you about the gunpowder?
Well, you said they were duds.
Oh, Mama's confused. She thinks those grenades are pineapples that Dottie and Clyde sent out from California. Well, don't just stand there like a government employee. Get in that powder room. Find those grenades. God. I'm not even comfortable smoking in there. Yeah, I live in fear. Mama's gonna walk into the kitchen to fix a fruit salad and blow us all the way to Tierra del Fuego. Hey. Hey. Sweep up whatever you spilled in there. Oh, God. Pitiful. Oh, I thought when the sky turned black on my wedding day, it was just Texas weather. Mama swore it was an omen, but I wouldn't listen. Oh, well, too late now.
Merry Christmas, Dee Dee.
Well, come on in, Pearl.
Oh, thank you, honey. Well, I like your tree.
Pearl, I've been meaning to call you. Why didn't you do a yard display this year?
Well, I'm throwing in the towel, Dee Dee. Vera Clark wouldn't let go of that trophy if you sprayed her with mustard gas.
Well, maybe she will, maybe she won't. Now, that giant tree of mine out there is going to be hard to top, but you know, I really thought you had a contender last year with that Christmas at Colonel Sanders.
Oh, well, it took me too long to get all those chickens in their little elf costumes. Well, Dee Dee, I think I'm looking for a gun.
Well, I thought you had a gun, Pearl.
But no, I threw it away after I shot my second husband.
Is that the sleepwalker?
Well, he should have told me that. Dee Dee, I think I'm looking for something to kill blue jays with.
Well, have I got a gun for you. Now, this here is a Canadian hummingbird derringer. There you go. It's light. It's easy to handle. You can keep it in your purse, and it'll blow the fuzz off a gnat's ass at 35 yards.
I don't know, Dee Dee. A gun's too loud. My hens won't lay.
No problem. R.R., see, we got any poison bird seed in there?
No, poison's out. I quit using that after I killed Henry's bird dog.
Never mind, R.R. Make me a cup of hot chocolate while you're in there. Try not to scald the milk. God, pitiful. Well, let me think.
Oh, Dee Dee, there's snakes in your drawer.
Oh, don't worry, Pearl. Those snakes are rubber. Hey, now, they're great for scaring off pests. Yeah, you sprinkle a few of these babies around the yard, those blue jays won't slow down till they hit Oklahoma.
I don't know, Dee Dee. I can't be around anything that don't have feet.
Well, some people are funny that way. You know, I left one of those rubber snakes in my sister's mailbox one time.
Yeah, well, you know, she screamed like white trash at a tent meeting.
Yeah, she sure did. She claimed it sped up her hair loss, but hell, Dottie's hair has always been so thin you could count
it. Oh, heavens. I've seen better hair on anchovies.
Well, back to your bird problem, I guess the only thing left is the old slingshot and ball bearing routine.
Yes, and I've got all those marbles I've had at home for years. I got them for Bertha's kids when they were little, and Charlene swallowed so many I put them away, but I've still got them.
That is smart, Pearl. One person's clutter can be another person's weapon. My mama always taught me that.
Dee Dee, how is your mama? Is Mimi feeling better? Dixie said she tried to cut off all her hair.
Oh, hell, she did. Mama's just going downhill every day. She nearly gassed us twice last week. Twice. Tried to fry Rice Krispies the other day. Oh. Yeah, we're looking for a home for her now, but it damn near kills me. And this morning, she hops out of bed, says she's the Phantom.
Well, you need to find her a home, quick.
Well, it gets worse. She said you and Dixie DeBerry put her up to it.
No.
I tell you, Pearl, a mind is the first thing to go. Let me get her out. She'd love to see you.
Oh, no, Dee Dee, honey, don't
Mama.
Disturb her, please. Oh, dear.
Mama. Mama, Mama. Now you're gonna mop that up. Oh. Mama, Pearl Burris is here. Oh, you remember Pearl, Mama, Pearl. Pearl, never mind what scared her off. Oh, well, put it on her bill. Did you find them?
Find what?
The grenade. God. Damn it, that's what I sent you in there for.
I forgot, Dee Dee, I forgot, but I found that old National Geographic.
Oh, yeah, I bet. Useless. God, I'd do it myself. Stay here, look after the customers. Don't cross that line.
God, if you were a cat, I'd have you fixed. Hey, Earl.
Hi, Petey. Hi, Fresno. Don't let Dady say Fresno. She shoots coyotes on sight.
Well, it's only half coyote, and nearly turned him into a vegetarian.
Well, she shoots vegetarians, too, so watch out.
You seen any UFOs lately?
Not any big ones. What happened to your friend?
Oh, Fresno regressed. I think he's just a little low on protein. I was wondering, do you sell muzzles?
No, Dady said they're a waste of shelf space. Why, have a guard dog if it don't bite. She'll be
I
right
gotta
there.
Run! Bye, Roar.
Bye, Petey.
Our God. Damn it. I want you to get into this Mason tear gas department, put everything back into alphabetical order. God, this is no way to run a business.
I'm right on it, Dee Dee.
Yeah, and that milk's boiling over. Mama told me I was marrying the original missing link, but I wouldn't listen. Oh, well, too late now. Sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? In the... Listening.
Hey, Dee Dee, how are you?
Well, I was fine till just now. Whatever you want, we're out of.
Yeah, well, you know, you should have been a comedian, you know that?
Well, I'll accept that as a compliment coming from the town joke. Yes, I'm sure. You've been wagging that gun around for years, not one notch on it. You're an example of wasted tax dollars.
Yeah. Well, what do you think about this? I'm requisitioning all your bookkeeping records and receipts.
Now, don't tell me someone went and taught you how to read.
Aw, hell, Dee Dee. Now, look, I'm doing some undercover work tracking down that Christmas thing.
Well, I ain't showing my records to nobody.
Yeah, well, you might as well cooperate, because you make me come back, I'll bring a subpoena.
Hey, you think you're going to waddle in here and snoop in my bookkeeping? You better bring a Chinese dinner for six.
Yeah, well, you know, you make it damn hard for me to do my job, too, Dee Dee.
Hey! You lay a finger on my filing cabinet, you'll scratch your ass with a stump for the rest of your life.
Hey, Dee Dee, you got a minute?
Maybe. That depends on what you're buying.
And now, I bet a good customer, you know that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the last thing you bought from me was a quarter's worth of BBs for that dim kid of yours.
Hey, now, he never had any problems till he ate all that plant food. Say, Dee Dee, have you seen Hank Buehmiller?
You know, Ike, I was in such a rush to get to work this morning, I didn't even have time to check the gutters.
Oh, hell, that ain't funny, Dee Dee. Shoot, I just talked to Bertha. I got to find Hank or it's going to be a blue, blue Christmas for a whole lot of folks.
Well, boo-hoo-hoo, I repeat. Are you here to buy anything?
No, but I'll be back for that later. Right now, I gotta find her.
Well, Bertha's parking her car across the street right now. Why don't you ask her?
Adios, amigo.
You better find Hank Buehmiller. It'll be vaya con Dios. Good King, what's his name, went down. Dee Dee's used weapons, we can't kill it, it's immortal. Hello, Dottie. Yeah, it's usually bad news, and you call Dottie. What's the matter? You're playing late, what? What do you mean you're not coming? Oh, great. Why? Oh, hell. Ah, hell. He's always had that. Well, don't they have antifungal creams in California, Dottie? Well, you still got to come get Mama. No. Now, I had her last Christmas. I know you took her for Easter, Dottie. She still got egg dye in her hair. under her nails, God knows where else. We can't even take her to church. Oh, well, I got a Christmas wish for you, too, Dottie. Yeah, yeah, I hope Santa craps down your chimney. Oh, it is hell being a twin.
Hello, Dee Dee, are you busy?
Well, come on in, Pickles. Have a cup of coffee. I'm never too busy to stop and chat with you.
Well, I thought you might be frazzled with this last-minute rush.
Business is always brisk when that phantom's on the loose. You be sure and thank Stanley for me.
Well, I hope the cops never catch you.
Hell, Sheriff Givens couldn't catch a cold in the Klondike. Yeah.
Well, Dee Dee, I really stopped by to see if you have any burglar alarms left.
Well, I sold my last one yesterday. You having a problem with prowlers?
No, no, nothing like that. Just something to wake me up when my worthless husband comes sneaking in late at night.
Oh, has Hank been out tomcatting again?
Oh, Dee Dee, I tell you, it's so embarrassing when the whole town knows my husband is as useless as ashtrays in hell.
Don't get me started. R.R.'s been on a wandering binge lately. You know, Bertha, I often wonder how such well-brought-up girls like you and me could have married so bad.
It's a mystery.
R.R.'s drinking's only gotten worse. He wanders off so much, I decided I better find out something about safe sex.
Oh, Dee Dee, I swear, Lord.
Can you imagine how depressed I got when I found out that's what we'd been doing all along?
Well, I suppose some things are better left unknown.
Amen, hallelujah.
Was that Ike Thompson I saw leaving?
There is another one just as worthless as titties on a boar hog. But back to your Hank problem. Now I'll order that burglar alarm for you.
Oh, that's all right, Dee Dee. I'll just do what I've always done.
What's that?
Rearrange all the furniture and unscrew all the light bulbs.
Pickles. Ooh, we sure knew what we were doing back in high school, and we voted you the class wit.
Oh, well, sometimes you have to laugh to keep from crying. Well, Dee Dee, I've got to run. It's going to take me a while to move that sofa. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Pickles. Don't strain your back. Just hear that ring, ring, ring-a-ling, ding, ding, ding-a-ling, ten. Because it's with you. Just hear that.
Okay, folks, we're back with Leonard's Let the Stops Out radio shopping spree. Now, folks, I haven't sold anything in weeks. I'm so desperate, I'll take hot checks. Where's your Christmas spirit? We got great merchandise here. Come on now, give me a call.
Leonard, Dee Dee Snively. No, I didn't call to buy nothing. I called to talk to you about that egg separator I bought from you last March. It had a 10-month guarantee. Yeah, it broke in 9 and a half. What do you mean you don't want to talk about it on the air? Well, maybe you'd rather talk about that red-headed bank clerk from Sand City you go bowling with every other Friday night. Yeah, I know your wife could be listening. I hope to God she is. Can you hear me, Reba? Reba, can you hear me? Hey, Leonard, Leonard, get a grip. Hey, Leonard, don't talk to me about ruining your Christmas. Leonard, my husband's a drunk who sees flying saucers. My mama's lost what's left of her mind. My sister Dottie had to call up and show her butt. My Christmas has been ruined. I just thought I'd ring you up and ruin yours. Well, I just saw Reba heading your way in her Land Rover. If I were you, Leonard, and I wanted to see New Year's in one piece, I'd start dashing through the snow. Jingle bells, jingle the way.
You just hold still long enough for me to get a bead on you.
Pearl?
Stanley, come out, set a spell. I'm out here trying to kill these blue jays.
Well, you don't give up on the blue jays, do you, Pearl?
They're so loud, they've got my banty rooster upset, and he's got my hen so nervous they quit laying. I'm losing egg money hand over fist. Pull up this chair here, honey. I want to talk to you.
What is it, Pearl?
Stanley, I'm worried. There was a white mule in my dream last night.
That's not a sign of death, is it, Pearl?
No, God, no. That's a white horse. A white mule is usually nothing worse than car trouble. Honey, I'd appreciate it if you'd look under the hood of that Pontiac before you go. Well,
sure, I'll be glad to. Hey, you know who I dreamed about? Do you remember that weenie dog you had that could spell?
Oh, Doc the Dashhound, yes. Oh, we got him from Petey Fisk. At the time, we didn't know he was a cat hater.
I ain't ever seen anything like it. You say the word cat, he'd go hog wild.
Well, it got so bad we couldn't say cat. We tried spelling it, and he still went crazy.
He could spell cat?
Yeah, we had a spelling dog.
Whatever happened to that dog, Pearl?
Old Doc, Mildred Jean Perkins' cat killed him.
Yeah. What was that cat's name?
Itty Bitty.
Itty goddamn bitty. Yeah. Who in the hell would name a cat that size itty bitty?
Oh, that brain-damaged child of theirs, Randy. He wasn't right in the head, but they let him name that cat.
Well, how did Itty Bitty kill Doc?
Well, she rolled on her back over there across the street and just lured poor old Doc right out there under the wheels of a Lone Star beer truck.
Oh. Damn. Boy, it's shame lose a good dog like that that could spell.
Yeah, well, it's too bad you didn't have your taxidermy license at the time. You could have stuffed old Doc for us. It's the only way to have an animal, stuffed, hanging on the wall. And then all you got to do is dust them once a week.
Yeah, well, they don't keep you up at night.
No, you're so lucky to have a skill. You should leave, Tuna. The folks around here will keep you looking back. You need to get out and tackle life. Use your gifts. Don't be like me and throw away a skill.
I never knew you had a skill, Pearl.
Oh, yes. I was a riveter in Houston back during the war.
A riveter?
The Japs never sank one of my ships. No, honey, I put in so much overtime, all my fillings flew out. I had to quit. Stanley, has your daddy come home?
Oh, hell, Pearl, daddy's never home.
Well, you make sure your mama has a good Christmas.
Yeah, I got her a gift certificate down at Conoco, 5 free oil changes.
Yeah, well, staying out of trouble is Christmas present enough. What do you want Santa Claus to bring you?
Bus ticket out of this black hole, I don't know. Out west be nice. Your friend Dixie DeBerry ain't making my life any easier.
How so?
Oh, she making a fuss down at the little theater.
Yeah, and how's that going?
Nobody knows their lines are all fighting like cats in a bag. And Joe Bob's blaming the Phantom and says he's got everybody so upset they can't think. They're all looking at me out of the corner of their eyes. I tell you, Pearl, I've had it up to my ass, this sorry excuse for town, and somebody's gonna pay.
Honey, don't lose your head.
Once I get off probation,
I'm gonna sneak down to the 4-H barn and I'm gonna spray paint the private parts on all the livestock. Let them hang blue ribbons on that.
You don't want to do that.
I got me a defang rattlesnake's gonna wind up in somebody's commode. I just haven't decided whose yet.
Yeah, well, that'll keep them regular.
Yeah, and I tell you, Sheriff Gibbons had better stop following me around like a bird dog. Damn. He's determined to catch me doing something.
Oh, Buford Gibbons is loopy. Always has been. Honey, when he was a teenage boy, he wet the bed at church camp. It was terrible. They called him rubber sheets.
Rubber sheets. Rubber sheets, Gibbons. Ooh, I like the sound of that. Well, old rubber sheets ain't gonna catch me doing diddly. Once this play's over, I'm gonna get even and get the hell out of Dodge.
Oh, my God, Stanley, I just had a revelation. If Dixie shuts the lights off on Christmas Carol, you won't complete your probation. Well, she's got to extend. That's all there is to it. And I forgot about the Phantom.
Phantom?
Never you mind. You get Dixie over here quick.
Carl, Dixie ain't gonna listen to me. I'm a felon.
Well, tell her it's a red alert.
Oh, what the hell?
Go, honey, go. Hello. Is Sheriff Gibbons there? Put him on. Sheriff, this is Pearl Burris. I want to report a theft. 4 of my Rhode Island Reds are missing. Well, I got up this morning. They were gone. Do you suppose it was the Phantom? Well, you've got to drive by here more often. I'm a taxpayer. Those hens are my livelihood. Oh, you don't have time, I see. Well, you'd find time if that Phantom stole your rubber sheets. You just hold still now. Stop that hopping around.
Pearl?
Shh.
Pearl, why'd you send that slobbering hippie over to my house?
Dixie, don't distract me now. This marble has that blue jay's name on it. Nose hair off.
Now, Pearl, you're going about this all wrong. You gotta think like a bird if you want to kill one, sing to him.
Oh, I never heard of anybody singing to a blue jay.
Well, you damn sure never killed one, neither.
Well, I hope they like the Andrew sisters.
Oh, there he is, Pearl. Sing, sing.
Down in the meadow in the itty-bitty pool, swim 3 little fishies and a mama fishy too.
Swim, take the mama fishy, swim if you can, and a swim right over the dam.
Oh! Yeah, well, he'll get the word out.
Maybe you should sing something more contemporary, Pearl.
Yeah. Dixie! Ah!
Pearl, don't scare me like that.
My heart's
not strong. I'm older than alley-oop. I can't take loud noises.
Dixie, I just remembered you can't shut the lights off on Christmas Carol.
Says who?
My nephew Stanley has to be in that damn fool play to complete his probation.
Sit down, Pearl.
Why, it'll ruin Christmas for all of us if he doesn't get off. And Rubber Sheets is watching him like a hawk. If he slips up once, he's a goner.
And I'd like to help you, Pearl, but I can't. Why? If I let that little theater off their light bill, every light bill in town would go unpaid. That's revenue, Pearl. That's how we pay for stop signs and do not litter signs. And if that money runs out, the traffic will get snarled and the litter will pile up till you just knee deep in garbage and hot rodders, and then your insurance rates will go sky high. Filth and disrespect breed crime, Pearl, which draws gambling and mafia, and the next thing you know, we'll have paramutual betting, liquor by the drink, parallel parking on Sunday. We won't be able to drive for the whiskey bottles, and before you can say scat, the communists will just be pouring across the Rio Grande, and that'll be the end of civilization as we know it.
Look, all I'm asking
no,
is what...
No! Let her go. Stanley wants to get off probation? Well, hell, he can... Well, he can... Mm. Well, he can drag his worthless butt down to the welfare office and lick stamps for me, but I'm not turning my hometown over to Fidel Castro, and that's that look. Pearlie's back.
Don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me. With anyone else but me. With anyone else. Ah, you dirty bird, you.
Maybe he'd like some Lionel Richie.
Yeah. Dixie!
Pearl, you did it again!
Well, we're in trouble. We're in big, big trouble. Mimi Bird's been babbling. She told Dee Dee the three of us are the Phantoms.
She's got to shut up.
I know.
She's got to shut up or we'll all be wearing striped pajamas. This is all your fault, Pearl. I told you Mimi be the one to crack. She nearly got us caught in 32.
Well, don't you just think you ought to be calm because you're too damn old to be here behind a jail bar. And I told you that
I'll drag you across that fence. I'm going to take this part.
Rubber sheets. Sit down, Dixie, quick. Wave to him. Wave. We're just out here being old ladies. Well, I think we're safe. Who's going to believe an old woman like Mimi with all that egg dye in her hair?
God, she looks like death chewing on a cracker. Oh, but the heat'll be on now. Oh, we won't be able to be the Phantom anymore. It's always been my favorite part of Christmas. I guess our party's over.
Yeah. Our bubbles burst.
It's our last waltz.
End of the line.
Adios, amigos.
Sayonara.
22.
Good night, Irene.
Good night, Irene. Good night, Irene. Give me the slingshot. Oh, there is a rose in Texas, the finest ever grew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds. They sparkle like the dew. You can talk about your clementine.
Ha! Bingo!
Never knew what hit it.
Good shot there, Dixie girl. Good shot. Well, that's it, honey. Well, that's it. We'll save him for Stanley and have him stuffed.
Walk now, loudmouth.
Yeah. You know, Dixie, I've been thinking, it's not like that Christmas Phantom to up and disappear. Just because one old woman with cake coloring in her hair and one foot in the grave starts rambling.
You know, it might look suspicious at that.
Well, if that Phantom is down to his last prank, I think it ought to be a doozy.
I haven't seen a look like that in your eyes since you snatched the toupee off that faith healer back in Wichita Falls.
Oh, my God. Well, he claimed to heal the sick and he couldn't even grow hair. Oh, Dixie, honey, we've got to put our thinking caps on. Only the best yard will do. She's had it coming for 15 years. You can talk about your Clementine and sing of Rosalie, but the yellow rose of Texas is the only girl for me.
Merry Christmas! This is radio station OKKK broadcasting live from the Tuna High School Gymnasium where the social event of the Christmas season is underway.
Yes, folks, in a few minutes we'll all know the winner of the OKKK Christmas Yard Display Contest, and the tension is mounting. It is.
It is.
It is. It is. Will Vera Carpen family claim 15 wins in a row in spite of her disastrous experience tonight due to the Christmas Phantom?
Or will Dee Dee Snagley claim first place despite retina damage to two of the judges?
And we can't count out Helen and Anita, whose dark horse entry could surprise. And now the moment of truth has arrived as Thurston will announce this year's winner.
You'll have to read it all as hell. My hands won't stop shaking.
God almighty, give me that. And the winner of the OKKK Christmas Yard Display Contest and the nonstop weekend in Laredo goes to Anita Goodwin and Helen Baird for All I Want for Christmas.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. I just don't know where to start.
We want to thank our boyfriends who inspired the whole display.
That's right. Muchas gracias to Donnie and Danny.
Kenny Ray, Preston, Garland.
Duke, Clayton, and Dwayne.
Yeah. And Randy. Randy.
Yeah. Wait a minute, what is going on over there?
Well, it looks to me like Vera Carp has fainted. Isn't that just like her at our big moment?
Y'all leave her alone. She's going to be hell to deal with when she comes to.
I want to say something now. You know, there are times in life when everything just starts to get to you. I don't know, for those of us in the food service business, there are days when the grill is smoking and the ice machine is spitting cubes at you, and poppy seeds are falling off the buns. It's just easy to question whether Tuna can offer enough to aspiring career women like us. And then something like this just comes out of the It just encourages me so much. I just want to go back to school and get my GED.
Well, you know, I'm real grateful. I really am, but I'm not going that far.
And we want to recognize the other finalists.
Oh, yeah, we do. We do. And somebody tell that to Vera when she comes too. Now that's out of the way, this girl's ready to rock and roll!
So we'll see everybody at the OKKK party later tonight.
That's right. If Dixie shuts the lights off on that play, we're just going to start early. Helen, is that Sheriff Givens out there putting a ticket on your Mitsubishi?
Why, sure is.
Get away from that truck, rubber sheets. Let's get out of here. Come on.
Hey. Hey. You put a ticket on my pickup truck, I'll slip something in your chili dog next time you come in. Bye.
There'll always be a honky tonk with a jukebox in the corner and someone crying in their beer and one old hanger over and a lady looking lonely from losing love.
Helen, Helen, turn on that music and I'll hit the grill.
With an OKKK early evening news quickie. Well, it's all over but the screaming as Tuna's annual yard display contest is over and Helen Bed and Anita Goodwin have broken Vera Carp's stranglehold on the trophy. But it seems they had some help from the Christmas Phantom who struck the Carp's yard in a big way.
He did.
It seems when the judges arrived at the Carp's yard earlier this evening, someone had put boxer shorts on the shepherds, the wise men, and Joseph, and the Virgin Mary was wearing an ERA button.
Arliss, I was wondering if we laughed till our sides hurt.
They did.
We did?
They did.
That's probably what stampeded those sheep.
They're still missing.
They are.
But if anyone finds those sheep, you can leave a message for Vera Carp at the clinic where she is recovering in the trauma unit.
Now, visiting hours just started.
So go down there and get in line.
Taste cream, Helen speaking. How may I help you? Oh, hi, Charlene. Hang on. Okay, shoot. All right, that's one double cheeseburger, chili in the works, large fries, large DP, large fried pie, one grilled cheese, grilled in margarine, not butter, trim the bread, hold the mayo, one diet DP. You know, Joe Bob would be a lot less temperamental if he'd get off that diet. I am just trying to help. God, are you sensitive? Anita, one wimpy cheese delight, one sweat hog special with natural gas.
Oh, my God, Helen, we got a crisis.
What now?
I was so nervous about the contest, I forgot to thaw the hamburger meat. If we have a rush, Vernon will can me.
Oh, calm down. I got my hair dryer back here in my bag. Just use that to thaw it out.
Good idea. Where would I be without you?
Unemployed. You better hurry up that meat, boy. Joe Bob's going to have a fit if we're late with his supper.
Oh, Joe Bob needs to take a powder.
And you know what? I got some pain under PM out in my pickup truck. I think I'll slip a couple in his diet DP just to calm him down.
Good idea. I'll watch the window. Taste of cream. I need to speak. What can I do you for? Yes, Charlene, I'll remember to trim Joe Bob's bread. Yes, I'll remember to hold the mayo. Charlene, have I ever forgotten your large fried pie? Goodbye.
Hey, Anita.
Oh, hi, Farley.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Are you coming to the party?
Well, we'd love to. We're a little short on time. Well, what's so funny?
Nothing. God, you little people are edgy. What can I do you for?
Give me two baby burgers and a medium fries.
Well, you know, you must be hungry today.
No, I got Phoebe out in the truck with me. We're going to split the fries.
Yeah, well, there she is. I can just barely see the top of her head. You know, she sure can't rock that hair.
Oh, she wouldn't be 4 feet tall without it.
Hi, Phoebe, darling. Merry Christmas.
She can't see you. The seat's too low, but I'll tell her you said hi. How long did Phoebe take?
Well, I'll have it for you in a jiffy.
Well, thanks, you big old corn-fed thing, you.
Julio, get off of Helen's hood. Sit on your own hood. And now, Hector, you can't park there. You are not handicapped. Yet. Hi, Petey. I hope you didn't bring that coyote with you again.
Oh, Fresno's only half coyote. Hardly ever bites.
Well, what can I do you for?
Well, I just came by to see if you got any leftover lettuce for Paula.
Oh, no, Petey. Look, Vernon don't want me throwing anything away. Now, he finds out I'm giving leftover lettuce to a lizard. I'm in deep stuff.
Paula ain't just any old lizard. She's a Mexican iguana with special dietary needs.
Iguana. Oh, God. Joe Bob Lipsy did a whole play about them once. Lots of nasty stuff about underwear salesmen. I hardly understood half of it.
Well, that sounds weird.
Well, it was weird. This whole town thinks you're weird.
Well, what do you expect from a place that has an elk hunting season and no elk?
Yeah. Well, you're right there. There's not an elk within 1,000 miles of here. Look, Petey, I got some romaine that's about gone, but I can't let you have that leaf lettuce. We're running
well,
low.
Well, thanks. Anyway, Paula's got a real bad reaction to romaine. Last time I gave her romaine, she bit me right between the eyes.
God, just get out of here, Petey, and take that four-legged handbag out there with you.
Well, I never.
Well, all right. Wait a minute. Here. Ain't nobody going to be eating salads on Christmas Eve. Merry Christmas.
You too, Anita. Paula says thanks.
Yeah. God, the meat.
girl. Taste cream, Helen speaking. How may I help you? I need a flop one, cheesy, greasy, let it bleed.
Okie dokie, tell that Pearl Merry Christmas.
Miss Burris, Anita says Merry Christmas. You too. You want shaved ice or cube ice with that? Okay. Well, thank you. Well, what a nice thing for you to say. You know, we're real proud that we won. I guess you really ought to thank the Phantom, though. Hello? Hello? She hung up on me.
Helen! Helen, have you seen my wife, Helen?
Well, not yet, Leonard, but you know that looks like her Land Rover pulling up right now.
Helen, I'd appreciate it if you'd not tell her you seen me.
You should have thought twice before you married a wilderness scout, Leonard. Taste of cream, Helen speaking. How may I help you? Oh, yeah, Charlene, yeah, I remembered. That was a large Diet DP for Joe Bob. Uh-huh. It'll be about 10 minutes. We have a problem. I don't want to get into it. Yes, I know Joe Bob is hypoglycemic. Listen, Charlene, you tell Joe Bob he sets foot in Anita's kitchen, he will be hypoglycemic with a limp. I hate this job.
Well, has Charlene called my order in?
Ah, Joe Bob, Anita. Joe Bob is here for his order.
Look, I am hypoglycemic. I need food.
Sit down, Joe Bob. You look weak.
Well, I haven't eaten in at least 3.5 hours. I'm going in there and cook it myself.
Oh, that's a real bad idea, Joe Bob. Now sit down. Sit down. Now I have a big old jumbo Diet DP.
Thank you.
Can I get you something to munch on while you wait?
Anything. Peanuts, breadcrumbs, you can dip a napkin in ketchup. I need nutrition.
Here, Joe Bob, you just munch on those chips, okay?
Yeah. Well, that'll help. God, they're stale.
Well, I just serve them. I don't preserve them.
Yeah. About as stale as this town. You have no idea how I've suffered. I've not had this many problems since that all-white production of Raisin in the Sun.
Oh, I just love that one. It was so funny.
Yeah. And an hour from now, I'm looking at an opening with a lead that can't find his teeth.
How about a moon pie?
And Stanley Buemiller keeps slouching in the street scenes like some thug.
Big hunk.
The ghost of Christmas past dips snuff, carries a little spit cup. Anita keeps belching.
Open wide for Chunky.
I ask the costumer for scars. Scars! I get bandanas. I'm doing Christmas Carol, not Rio Bravo. I'm going in there.
How about a pickled egg? Mm-hmm.
You know, I am bigger than this town.
I heard that.
Do you know what I am?
No, what?
I'm a professional.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I've been to Waco. I have worked the professional theaters from Corpus Christi to Flagstaff. Dixie DeBerry thinks she's gonna cut off my light. She can kiss my rosy pink butt.
Anita, you need to get that food out here. I'm about to get sick. Taste cream, Helen speaking. How may I help you? Well, yeah, but he's eating. Well, you know how he is when you get near his trough. Hang on. Joe Bob, it's for you. It's Charlene. She sounds real freaked out. Now, you be nice to her.
What is it, fifth wheel? Charlene, I can't understand you. Why are you crying? You're afraid of the dark. She what? She what? That old horned frog cut off my lights.
Oh, Joe Bob, I'm so sorry.
That's all right, Helen. There's only one thing I want out of this town before I leave.
What?
My grilled cheese sandwich, and I'm going in there to get
Joe Bob, no.
Just get out of my way.
I can't let you do that.
I'm not going to
try. I need to throw
stuff. I'm coming in there.
I hate this job.
Joe Bob, you better get out of my kitchen. Get out of my way, Moose. Look, I'm warning you, Thumbelina. Oh, now get out, get yourself another street urchin. Helen, will you do me a big favor?
What?
If I am still in this town next Christmas, will you take me out somewhere and shoot me?
Oh, Joe Bob, I couldn't do that. But I'll get one of my boyfriends to shoot you. They'd be glad to.
I need a nap.
Yeah. Bye. Break the leg. Maybe I shouldn't have said that. Anita, you okay?
Never better. Hey, Helen. Helen, how did you get over here? How long is our food gonna be?
Oh, it'll be just a sec. We have a small crisis.
Oh, yeah. Well, honey, just how long does it take you to cook two little tiny baby burgers? What'd you have to do, go out there and stop that stare?
Listen, paperweight, we're having a bad day. Now, your food'll be right out.
Oh, really? Well, I hope so, because we are just about to waste away out here.
Tasty cream, Helen speaking. How may I help you?
Randy, no trouble at all. All time in the world. You want? You have a present for me?
You should know. No, we're not too busy. Tell what, better meet me out back though, in case Vernon comes by. Boy, I'd hate to get canned on Christmas Eve.
Ooh, you too. Ooh, I'm heading that way.
Bye. Anita, you gotta cover the front for a minute.
Have you got nuts? I am up to my knockers in frozen patties. You wanna rush off somewhere? There's no excuse for this, Helen.
Yes, there is.
Like what?
Randy.
Go for it, girl. Tasty cream, I need a speaking. What can I do you for? Look, Charlene, it's his own fault for coming in my kitchen. No, he started it. Charlene, get yourself a real man. We're so tired of watching you bark up the wrong forest. Get out that hard, midget!
Hey. Hey, Anita.
Oh, hi, Garland. Come on in. Take a load off.
I'm on duty. I just come by to see if you need some more soda water.
We're fine, cute stuff. You know, Garland, I sure wish you came in cans. I'd pop your top every 5 minutes.
You crack me up, Anita. You know that.
Yeah, well, whatever works. Look, Garland, you can do me a big favor.
Yeah, what's that?
Come around back and help me thaw hamburger meat.
Well, I'm on duty, but... I'll do you a favor just once.
Well, I'll do you one later.
You crack me up, Anita. You know that?
Garland, use Helen's hair dryer to thaw that meat. Tasty cream, I need to speak, and what can I do you for? Hi, Vernon.
Look, we are real busy, Vernon. Nobody's drying their hair at work. I don't know. Clean out your ears. Tomorrow? What about tomorrow? Vernon, I am not working on Christmas Day. Who's going to eat out on Christmas Day? Your family. Well, they can all go over to your house and fill up on bologna. You can't fire me, Vernon, because I quit. And so does Helen. Yeah, well, you kiss me where I can't reach.
What's going on?
This is the worst Christmas of my life.
Well, what's wrong?
Vernon fired me.
He what?
Well, actually, I quit because he wanted to stay open on Christmas Day. And Kenny Ray is off in Fort Worth with my truck.
Well, you can use my Mitsubishi anytime you want.
No, I can't. Last time Daddy caught me in your Japanese truck, he boxed my ears. You know, he fought in the Philippines. We couldn't even eat rice growing up. Now I ain't got a job, no truck, no boyfriend.
Well, you still have me. And I work double shifts till you can get back on your feet. Oh,
Helen.
What are friends for? I mean, we'll have to cut back, but we'll make it. Pretty soon you'll be able to pay the back rent and overdue bills and for that stolen truck, and life will return to normal.
Helen.
I don't want to hear it. Now, as long as I got a job, you got a home. You just say that over and over and over in your mind. As long as Helen's got a job, I got a home.
Helen.
What?
You quit too.
I did. Anita, where are you gonna live?
Oh, I hate this
job. Always be a honky tonk with a jukebox in the corner and someone crying in their beer and one old hanger on and a lady looking lonely from a losing love affair. Yeah, there'll always be a honky-tonk somewhere. Yeah, there'll always be a honky-tonk somewhere.
Fresno? 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 Sit. Now, Fresno, I know you're half-caught, and you're not used to being stampeded by hostile sheep. But you bite me one more time, and you're going to be making the call of the wild. And you sheep, stay over by the gate. Don't stampede the coyote. This natural enemy thing's about to kill me. I'm down to my last arm and leg. One more injury, we'll all starve to death. And Paula, I know iguanas are prone to depression, but you're going to end up with a zipper and a snap if you don't lighten up. Y'all ought to be ashamed of yourselves. Where's your Christmas spirit? Hey, hey, stay calm, 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 stay calm. Now just stay calm and let me look for the star. Ah. There it is. Fresno. Ow. There it is.
It's shining like the very first Christmas. We were all a part of it. Shepherds were watching their flocks of sheep. By night, obviously, there was a coyote problem. And they saw that star. Mary and Joseph found no room at the inn, but the innkeeper said they could stay in the stable. And that's where the baby was born, among the cattle and the sheep and the iguanas. Look at that shine. You know, the light from that star left before there was even anybody here to see it. It's like looking at eternity, shining down on everything, peace on earth, goodwill to everybody. I never get tired of hearing that. Well, that's something to wish for. Come on, Fresno. Come on. Paula, come on, let's go inside. Girls, stay calm. Now, we all need our rest. Tomorrow is Christmas Day.
Oh, holy night, the stars so brightly shining. It is the... birth. That's one heavenly light. Fall on your knees. Where in the hell have you been?
Merry Christmas, Dee Dee.
Is it? God. Damn you, you did it again.
You weren't supposed to peek at your Christmas tree.
Oh, shut up. I put up with your drinking and your tardiness and your UFO sightings.
I
and God knows
that.
The books never balance, but this Christmas is the topper RR. I've dropped hints for 2 months that all I wanted for Christmas was Sal Mineo's greatest hits. And what do you give me? A clue game.
Well, we could talk
about... we can't return it now. Mama's already swallowed half the pieces.
I'm sorry, Dee Dee. I just thought maybe...
Damn it. If I could have one Christmas wish, it would be that one of your UFOs had picked you up tonight and haul your dead weight off to kingdom come. Fa la 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 la.
Thank you.
Sheriff. Sheriff Vera Carp. No, I'm not in the hospital anymore. No, being around all those sick people depressed me so bad. I was told the doctor to send a nurse home with me while I recover. Hang on.
Nurse. Would you set that oxygen tent up over by the TV? Well, this nurse is such a grump, you'd think I'd asked her for a kidney. Most people would be grateful for the work on Christmas Eve. Just my luck to bring home the Grinch, but back to business. I ran into Reba Childers over at the clinic. She was there getting Leonard's bone set. Hang on. Lippy, alto, alto, Lippy, alto, alto. Lippy, you put that fur coat in the washer, I'll take back your Christmas bonus. Well, she understood that. Where was I? Reba Childers. She examined the tracks around my yard display. She said there were two of them that did it. Females. Old. Old. Older than Egypt. One of them had combat boots, the other was a big old lady with a definite limp. Hang on, Virgil, put that down. Stop playing with that. That's not a toy boat. It's a bedpan. It won't float. Put the bedpan down now. Are you there? Well, what are you going to do? Well, I don't want to hear that. Well, I should have thought about that before. No, I wouldn't want to see anybody go to jail on Christmas Eve, but come New Year's, I want those old dinosaurs singing Auld Lang Syne in handcuffs. Hang on, Virgil, put that down. Get that out of your mouth. That's not that kind of thermometer. Let me call you back.
Merry Christmas, Pearl.
Stanley, honey, come in. You're just in time for a Christmas toddy.
Well, I got plenty of time, Pearl. Dixie shut off the lights before I could finish my community service. You should see the smile on Rubber Sheet's face.
Stanley, I've got tidings of great joy. I cut a deal with Dixie. She said you could lick stamps on next month's bills to finish your time. Well, I just finished licking them for you. You're free to go.
Well, hell, Pearl, you didn't have to do that.
Well, I wanted to. I'm just glad we're a small town. Yeah. Well, you know, one more stamp would have gagged me. Stanley, looky here, I've got something for you. It's a one-way ticket to Albuquerque, along with a little something extra, and you can thank your Uncle Henry for that spending money.
Pearl, why do you want me to go to Albuquerque?
Well, they say there's a lot of wildlife out there. You'll always have something to stuff.
Hell, Pearl, you think of everything, I am. I wonder what Mama's going
to
say.
Well, don't you worry about her. If Bertha ever needed to let something go, it's you. Now run along, honey. That bus won't wait.
I I don't know how to thank you, Pearl.
Well, just don't ever look back, honey. That's enough.
Goodbye, Pearl. You gonna kiss me goodbye?
No, honey, I've licked too many stamps. Well, you know, I'm afraid that I would stick to you.
Oh, hell, Pearl, you crazy.
Oh, honey, now don't you say that. I'm not.
This is Arliss Struby on Radio OKKK in Tuna, Texas. We're going to be going off the air early tonight so we can have our annual Christmas party here at the station. And everybody's invited to come on by, drop in, as long as you don't bring your kids. Because we don't want any fruit punch poured down our transmitter like last year. And we'd like to take this time to thank our sponsors here at Radio OKKK, Clifford's Piano and Organ Shop over in Sand City. Clifford wants you to know it's never too late to get your hands on a good organ. So come by Clifford's, talk it over, and remember, at Clifford's, they will hold your organ till Christmas. This is Radio Station OKKK in Tuna, Texas, signing off.
Knock, knock.
Oh, come on in.
Am I the first one here?
Yeah.
No matter how hard I try to make an entrance at a party, I'm the first one through the door. It's my destiny.
Well, at least you get to see all those Jell-O molds, all those appetizers, four folks eat them up.
Yeah, there's a fancy one. Now, what did she use to make the hooves?
You know, I kind of wonder where everybody is.
Well, I know Dee Dee said she wasn't coming because the party clashed with her TV schedule. You know, she won't miss Gunsmoke.
And see, Thurston went over to Sand City. Woolco had a special on bubble lights.
Yeah, and Leonard's still at the clinic.
None of us have seen Leonard since Dee Dee told the world about him going bowling with that red-headed bank clerk, but we hear old Reba tracked him as far as Amarillo.
Amarillo?
Oh, Reba can track a flea over concrete.
Yeah. And she's a good shot when she finds what she's tracking, too.
Mm-hmm. Deadly aim.
Well, I guess we shouldn't expect either one of them. Mm-hmm.
So is your husband coming by?
Oh, I haven't even seen him today. Hank's not very good at parties. Besides, he never was one for Christmas. Some of my worst memories of Hank are Christmas.
You know old Trudy be the same way. She'd get meaner than hell right around Pearl Harbor Day. And it could go all the way to St. Patty's.
How long were you and Trudy married?
14 years.
That's a long time.
Seem like 50. Now, hey, we're gonna talk about Trudy. I gotta have a snort. Do you
Do you want some?
No, thank you.
Well, just a little snort in your punch?
It's against my religion.
Who's gonna tell on you?
I really
well, couldn't. If you really don't want any now,
well,
I'm just
one little shot in my mouth. That's Maxi Bovine's punch, I recognize.
It's a bitter.
That's much better. What were we talking about?
About how awful Christmas can be.
Oh, well, you know, it used to be terrible when the kids were little. Hank would get drunk and put all the toys together the wrong way. And then he'd get mad and disappear. But you know, the worst Christmas ever was the Christmas Hank got out of prison and didn't bother to tell anybody. I spent all Christmas Eve on a bus to Huntsville and him not even there. And then turning around, coming home on Christmas Day, 9-year-old twins fighting every inch of the way. And Jody was just a baby, and it was cold. Everybody had colds too. The whole bus was hacking. And at a rest stop in Big Spring, Stanley talked Charlene into climbing into an empty luggage compartment. Oh, locks her in and she screams blue murder for 10 solid minutes till I could find a driver and let her out. I'd have whipped them both had it not been Christmas. And it was cold.
Well, you know, now the worst Christmas I can remember was the year that Trudy got mad and moved the trailer house one day while I was at work.
Oh, dear. Well, why?
Oh, hell, she was mad. She wanted an archery set for Christmas. I told her no.
Why did she want an archery set?
I have no idea. But hell, our insurance was high enough because of her driving. I wasn't about to give her a bow and arrow.
Yeah. And she moved the trailer.
She moved it to New Mexico. just flat out ruined my Christmas.
Well, I can imagine having your home disappear across state lines like that.
Yeah. You want another snort?
Oh, no, thank you.
Well, now. Just a little whiff in your punch?
No, I couldn't.
A little dabble do you?
No,
well,
I
if you really don't want any now.
Well, just one little shot in my punch. Well, a little bigger than that.
One for you and three.
It's a shame now that nobody else showed up for this party.
It is. Yeah, I was hoping to get a little dancing in.
Oh, dancing. I didn't know there was going to be any dancing. I probably shouldn't even be here. You know, in my church, we don't dance.
You want another snort?
Why not? You know, one time in high school, Vera and I sneaked over to Sand City and went to a dance. Well, I let it slip one Saturday morning when Mama and I were cleaning the house, and she whipped me with a vacuum cleaner hose.
God almighty.
Well, Mama had a way of breaking your bad habits. Every time I shampoo rugs, I think about that time. I've never been dancing since. I don't even remember how.
Well, I'll show you.
Oh, hush. I'm Baptist.
Well, I am too. You know what? Whenever I go out of town on business or conventions or stuff, I tell folks I'm a Methodist and I have one hell of a good time.
You are lying.
One time we raised so much hell in Houston, I claimed to be an Episcopalian.
What was that like?
Well, I don't remember much about it. By the time I came to, I was back in Tuna feeling like a Baptist again.
Episcopalian, I wouldn't have the nerve to do that even for one night. Oh, Arliss, it must be something being a celebrity like you. You must have a lot of women after you.
You'd think so, wouldn't you? But, well, hell, truth is, ever since old Trudy and I split the sheets, hell, well, I kept every Saturday night open, but I always wind up playing Risk with Thurston or going over to Sand City with him for Chinese food.
A well-known broadcaster like you.
Doesn't figure, does it? I think the glare of the spotlight scares a lot of women off. And then Trudy said some mean things after that divorce, especially when the judge awarded me the trailer house. But hell, that trailer's been in my family for years.
Oh. Well, it's practically an heirloom. The whole town knows
yeah,
that.
Yeah, but on the other hand, look at you, Bertha. I mean, you got your kids, but Hank, God almighty. Makes me mad as hell to think that worthless husband of yours has had a loyal, well-fed gal like you waiting at home for him all these years, and he never took you dancing, not once.
Well, I told you, Arliss, we're Baptist.
I don't care. Even Baptist ought to sin once in a while. That's what church is for. It's a place you go to feel better after you've done some sinning. It ought to make you mad as hell that man never took you dancing.
It's beginning to, the more I think about it.
You want another snort?
Poor.
If I was Hank, I'd take you dancing twice a week.
Now, Arliss, oh, I spilled my drink. I need to go.
Stop. Don't budge an inch.
What?
It's the way them radio tube lights bounce off your bouffant.
My hair. Are there icicles in my hair? Arliss, I need to go home now.
Bertha, may I have his dance?
Arliss, I can't. It's not that I just think, well, why not? I always wondered what it felt like to be a Methodist.
Looked a lot like Daddy. Our Daddy looked a lot like him. like the way I had him pictured. Santa was so much too thin. He didn't come down the chimney, so Mama must have let him in. Santa looked a lot like Daddy. Our Daddy looked a lot like him. Well, they thought I was fast asleep and they thought I was tucked in bed. They never thought that I'd come a peeping or that I'd hear what was said. Santa put his arm around Mama and Mama put her arm around him. So if Santa Claus ain't Daddy, then I'm gonna tell on them. Well, Santa looked a lot like Daddy. Our Daddy looked a lot like him. It's not the way I had him pictured. Santa was so much too thin. He didn't come down the chimney, so Mama must have let him in. Santa looked a lot like Daddy, and Daddy looked a lot like him.